Hi, fellow Outlander fans. How good is it to have it back on our screens? We're going to do a review of episode 9, aka The Reckoning. So if you've already seen it, let us know what you thought in the comments below. And please be aware this review will contain mild spoilers. So firstly, let's explore the title, The Reckoning. This is defined as either a person's opinion or judgment, or the avenging or punishing of past mistakes or misdeeds. So both of these ideas are explored quite heavily in the episode. So as you'll remember, the last episode ended with Captain Blackjack Randall holding Claire hostage and Jamie bursting in at the last minute holding a gun. Well, it turns out the gun wasn't actually loaded, but that's okay because it backfired on Captain Randall and resulted in Jamie and Claire being able to escape. An obvious change in this episode is that Jamie is now the narrator instead of Claire, and we expect this to last until the end of the series now. It explores Jamie's backstory and focuses on his relationship with Claire from his perspective. Claire is now, if you like, a secondary antagonist, which I suppose is fair, although I was quite a big fan of her internal monologue and would have had no qualms with that lasting all season. But it is nice to hear Jamie's side, I suppose. Anyway, back to the synopsis. When they're escaping from Fort William, Jamie narrates that he could have killed Jack Randall if he'd wanted to, and maybe he should have. Maybe that would have been the right decision. But for me, this brought up the issue of the butterfly effect. And if you've seen my other reviews, you will know that I'm kind of obsessed with the butterfly effect and how it is yet to be explored in Outlander. You should also note that I haven't read the novels that the series is based on. Anyway, if Jamie had killed Jack, then Claire's husband Frank might never have been born. So this raises all sorts of complicated issues, but whether or not this holds any weight within the narrative is yet to be seen. So after Claire's rescued, the Mackenzie men are quite rightly very angry with her because she put all of their lives in danger. Jamie's also angry with her as well, but he quickly forgives her because they're in love. But then we see a new and very interesting strand in the narrative, namely Claire's status as Jamie Fraser's wife.
I don't have to do what you tell me to.
You do. You are my wife.
Obviously, she's a very independent woman and she has very liberal ideas of what it means to be a wife. But Jamie lives within the social constraints of 1743 and has a very different idea and sees it as his job to punish her for what she did wrong. I mean, that's not going to go down well.
My wife, whether you like it or not.
Well, I don't like it. I don't like it one bit.
And then we see quite possibly the strangest scene so far in the series. Jamie belting Claire. There's an odd sort of come and get me humour to it at first, but then Jamie just belts her bare bum quite graphically. It was an interesting viewing experience, to say the least. What do you think of that scene? Do you think it was portrayed in the right way? Do let us know in the comments below. So although the other men then forgive Claire because she's been punished, it does have quite a bad effect on her and Jamie's relationship. And this isn't helped by the fact that he has come onto really heavily by Leary, who's the girl that had a crush on him before he left.
We've counted the days till your return. I had no notion about yourself. And
wasn't it something I planned?
Then why? Why did you do it?
So their relationship has quite a few ups and downs in this episode, but ultimately it ends on quite a positive note, despite the growing tensions at Castle Leoch in general. Also, they find a clump of Blair Witch-style twigs that's been left under the bed, which seems to be a spell that's been cast on them to wish them bad luck or even death, and we're presuming that this has been left by Leary. There's been no mention of Frank Randall or anything from Claire's 1945 life, so it's a little bit awkward because she was going to just leave Jamie and return to him, but that all seems to have been brushed under the carpet for now. Although this could well be because Outlander is now narrated by Jamie, who of course has no idea about Claire's 1945 life at all. So apart from the absence of information on the 1945 time period, there aren't really any complaints. It's great to have Outlander back on our screens. If you've seen it, do let us know what you thought in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more outlandish videos. See you next time. Hello, you're watching The 86th Floor. Now, one of our favourite programmes ever, Outlander, is returning.